His quick wit and thumbs-up, thumbs-down movie reviews earned Roger Ebert fame as one of America's most prominent film critics. The Illinois native said his love of cinema came at an early age.
I started going to the movies when I was a child, like everybody did. My aunt would take me to the grown-up movies. My dad took me to see the Marx Brothers. I just love movies.
Ebert began writing film reviews for the Chicago Sun-Times in the late 60s, and in 1975 was the first film critic to win the Pulitzer Prize for criticism. In 1970, he dabbled in screenwriting, co-authoring Beyond the Valley of the Dolls with Russ Meyer.
Come on, Casey, let's split.
In 1976, Ebert teamed up with a competitor, Chicago Tribune film critic Gene Siskel, to host a weekly movie review program on local TV. Within a few years, it was put into syndication, and Siskel and Ebert's thumbs-up, thumbs-down rating system soon became their trademark.
Two thumbs up had never been applied before in human history to anything. The phrase, two thumbs up, was not in use. People said, thumbs up. And so today, when people say, I give it two thumbs up, they're quoting us. And so that's what we trademarked, because we didn't want every film critic in the country to start doing that.
In 1999, Siskel died from complications stemming from a brain tumor operation. The show's title was changed to Roger Ebert and the Movies. A short time later, fellow Sun-Times columnist Richard Roper became permanent co-host of the show, which was later titled Ebert and Roper.
And then you have all of these great actors, Roger.
Roger Ebert also published annual collections of his film reviews, as well as several film guides. Not one to be left behind, Ebert embraced social media, actively tweeting, never losing his voice despite battling both thyroid and salivary gland cancers, and undergoing numerous surgeries in recent years.
My legacy, if there is one, will have to do with supporting films that people might not have seen, and supporting directors that deserve support. Of course, I review the big blockbusters and the commercial films. But from the very beginning, it's been very important to me to go out and look for independent films, documentaries, first films by young directors, and foreign films. Because those are the ones people need to hear about.
Till then, the balcony is closed.
A.J. Hammer, CNN, New York.